Welcome to EPG Pathshala. This is Dr. Ankush Ambardar from Kurukshetra University, Kurukshetra. Today, I'll be taking up a topic from Tourism and Hospitality course, that is Front Office Operations and Management. And this today, I'll be taking up a topic that is Hotel Marketing. Well, in this module, we will be learning and understanding what marketing exactly is. We'll know the importance of marketing in hotel industry. We'll know the difference between product and services, and we'll understand the marketing mix for hotels. Marketing is a very complex term, usually, whenever one comes across this term, they think that someone will be speaking about advertising a product or a service to the consumers, but marketing is just not advertisement of products or services. It is a well-researched program which is followed by various organizations to bring their product in the market. For hotels, it is a very unique subject. Hotel industry is the one wherein the customers gets to feel and experience the different kinds of services that are offered by the hotels. If satisfied, they tend to return back to you or else they move to your competitors. Thus, marketing may be a business philosophy wherein the customers are given the first preferences. The marketing department of the hotel tries to identify the needs and wants of the customers, and according to the statistics given by the marketing department, the hotel's industry will provide or generate the specific product or services to satisfy the needs of the customers. Thus, marketing is not just advertising, it is an act where the entire organization decision-making process is customer-centered and everyone in the hotel is trying to satisfy the customers. Another important aspect of marketing concept is hotel organizations do not only work to earn profits from customers. Their long-term goal is to create customer value and serve them better than their competitors. In return, profits will be generated automatically. Now, when it comes to definition of marketing, different marketing gurus have defined marketing as per their own perspective. Philip Kotler said that marketing is satisfying needs and wants through an exchange process. This means that by transactional exchange of money, one can enjoy the services of hotel, and in return, the hotel will satisfy the needs and wants of that customer. American Marketing Association says the process of planning and executing the conception, pricing, promotion, and distribution of ideas, goods, and services to create exchanges that satisfy individuals and organizational objectives. There might be different definition of marketing prevailing in different books, but one thing is common to that marketing work towards the satisfaction of an individual customer. In this competitive area, the focus of marketing has shifted from customer satisfaction to customer delight. Earlier, marketing strategies used to focus on satisfying the customers by providing best of the services, but this concept has been criticized. The hotel industry experience just by satisfying the needs and wants through exchange process will not produce a long-term customer. Thus, the hotels nowadays build relationships with the customers, wherein they not only satisfy the customer needs and wants, but also give them such an overwhelming experience that the customer goes back with sweet memories, and as a result, given this loyalty to the organization. Importance of marketing for hotel industry. Initially, marketing was designed to promote the physical products which were manufactured by the companies But with the growing interest of the customers towards the service sector, the marketing of services became an important part of the marketing. When it comes to opening a new hotel, growing into a profitable business unit, introducing new products and services, marketing becomes very important. No matter how good the services of the hotel are for the success of any business unit, business idea, or business strategy, marketing becomes the single most important unit. For sustaining in the competitive world, it is of utmost importance that your customers know your exit and what you are offering to them. Marketing is an investment plan which will give you good return on your investment. Without a marketing plan, the companies often shut down and go bankrupt. Thus, marketing is the most important tool for hotel industry to survive in the global competitive market. Now, creating awareness. A good marketing plan would create awareness about your company to the prospective clients. The very existence of a business unit will depend upon how well it is known in the public. Until the prospective clients does not know about your existence, it becomes very tough for your hotel to grow. Thus, spreading this word that you are there and what is so unique about your hotel. Next, helps to increase sales. Once the prospect client knows that you are there in, he or she will often try out the services of the hotel, and if you are able to satisfy with them, the word of mouth often helps to attract more customers and gradually increase the sales of your hotel. Without a professional marketing plan in place, these sales will not pick up and the hotel will shut down. Next, gives a competitive edge. The proactive effort of effective marketing team helps the hotel to face the competition. They will often come up with unique ideas that will promote the hotel business and will maintain the personal relations with their prospective clients. Next, it generates brand loyalty. Since the core concept of marketing is to work for satisfaction of the customers, therefore, a good marketing plan will often exceed the customers' expectations from the hotel, which in turn will build a feeling of trust and mutual understanding between the hotel and the prospective customers, and later helps in building the loyalty towards your brand. Next, it helps in achieving objectives. Every organization has different objectives, and without a good marketing plan, it will be merely difficult to meet them. Marketing will help the organization to achieve sales targets, gain profitability, increased brand loyalty, and improved brand image. Next, it helps in improving the reputation. The success of the company will rest upon the reputation, and marketing helps in building perceptions of brand, wherein the customers are made aware of your brand and the uniqueness of your brand. The business and sales of the hotel will increase with the growth in your reputation. An effective marketing plan will build your brand through external and internal communication and will promote the quality of services that are offered by your brand. Next is product versus services. The marketing of products is a simpler task as compared to services. Since products are visible to the naked eye, therefore, they can be felt and touched by the human skin. These are the unite which can be stored and kept for a longer time and can be sold later, but same is not the case with services. The services are to be experienced by the customers. Thus, it is difficult to market something which cannot be seen. For example, unless you eat out in a restaurant, you will not come to know how the food tastes. Thus, the marketing for services is entirely different because the characteristics of services are different from physical goods. The following are the characteristics of services. Number one, intangibility. Anything that does not have any physical existence are considered to be intangible. Therefore, the services cannot be touched, held, smelled, or tasted. This is the basic characteristics of services which primarily differentiate it from physical products. This also means that how can something which cannot be felt, touched, or smelt can be marketed? This further brings uncertainty in the customers. Therefore, the hotels need to bring some tangible evidence in the services that they are offering. For example, in a restaurant menu, pictures of foods can be printed so that the customer can visualize what he is expecting from the kitchen. Next is inseparability. The services are produced and consumed at the same time. That is, they are produced simultaneously and cannot be separated. The goods are manufactured, stored, and consumed later, but in case of services, it is not possible to separate them from service provider. For example, to experience the service of well-trained professionals, the customer needs to be physically present in the hotel. Because service providers and customers are likely to be present at the same place for service delivery, therefore, the hotel needs to hire professionals who are experts in the hotel management field and further train the service staff and the customers to understand the service delivery system. Next is variability. Because service industry is people-oriented, the services offered by hotel industry are highly heterogeneous. The same service is experienced different by different individuals. Because of the location, providers, and timings, there is no consistency in providing service to the consumers. For example, the service quality in the restaurant during peak hours differs than the non-peak hours. Thus, standardization the services in hotel industry becomes a difficult task. To standardize services, it is important to have an effective training program for employees and standard operating procedures. These should be set as that each employee of the hotel follows the same steps of service delivery each and every time. Next is perishability. The services are highly perishable. They are not durable and only last for a short time. It is not possible that the services can be stored today and consumed tomorrow. For example, a hotel room which is not sold for today cannot be sold tomorrow, and the revenue is lost for that particular day. An empty cover in the restaurant cannot be stored for tomorrow to manage perishability. Different pricing techniques should be used by hotels so that maximum number of rooms can be sold for a particular day, like seasonal rates, discounts, promotions, etc. For managing service quality during peak hours, hiring of contractual staff can be of great help. Next is lack of ownership. The services that are consumed cannot be owned by the service user. They are used or hired for a specific period of time. For example, booking a room to the hotel for one night does not make you the owner of the hotel. You will simply stay for the night and the next day will check out of the hotel. Thus, you hired the services of the hotel only for 24 hours. Therefore, the services can never be owned. Because of the above mentioned characteristics of the services, the marketing strategies for hotels are unique and different. The marketing team ensures that the services that are being delivered by their organization are well perceived by the customers. For example, the high grooming standards of the employees of the hotel says a lot about the kind of services to be expected from the hotel. The hygiene standards being followed in the hotel define what kind of food will come out of the kitchen. It is ensured that training is imparted to all employees of the hotel to meet additional demands during the peak seasons. Additional staff is hired and for revenue maximization as well as seasonal rate is offered to the customers. Next is segmentation. Targeting and position for hotel industry. The hotel industry is very versatile and huge in nature, and it is not possible to satisfy everyone by giving one type of service. Thus, STP approach is used by hotel industry so that they maximize of the customers can be attracted to the hotel. Segmentation. Segmentation is merely dividing a heterogeneous larger group into a homogeneous smaller groups. In general, everyone is the customer for hotel industry, but it is not possible to support the satisfaction of everyone in the market. Thus, it is essential to divide market into smaller groups or segments based on the similar characteristics. Market segments can be divided into demography, geographic, psychological, and behavior of customers. Now, understanding the demographic segmentation, based on the demographic profile, the segmentation is done on the basis of income, age, social class, and lifestyle. For example, for a five-star hotel, the market segmentation will be high income class people. The hotel can also segment its market for corporate markets, leisure markets, and wholesalers. Geographic segmentation. Based on the location, the market is divided in smaller sections. They may be divided according to countries, states, regions. Due to globalization, a lot of international clients often visit the hotels. Therefore, the hotels are often aware of their international customers and other services to them according to their taste. For example, the foreign nationals do not like spicy food. Therefore, the chef of the hotel will see that the food which suits the palate of the customer is made. Next, psychographic segmentation. This kind of segmentation focuses on how the customer thinks and feels according to their personality and lifestyle and the social class. For example, for Burj Al Arab, a seven-star hotel in Dubai, the upper class of the society is the market segment of high-end hotels. Segmentation on the basis of behavior. It is based on the benefits that the customer expects by using the services of the hotel. Customers are divided into groups based on their product, knowledge, spending pattern, and loyalty. For example, the customers who are purely vegetarian will not visit non-vegetarian restaurants. A business client uses the services of the hotel more as compared to a leisure traveler. By knowing the behavior of the customer, the hotel can put its best foot forward to enhance the services of the hotel. Next is targeting. Once the initial step of segmentation has been successfully achieved by the hotels, it will use to find out the best potential clients from the market, who are their target markets, and will give revenue to the hotel. Next is targeting. Once the initial step of segmentation has been successfully achieved by the hotels, it will use to find out the best potential clients from the market, who are their target markets, and will give revenue to the hotel. The hotel needs to have themselves to the best clients for them so that a specific marketing plan can be put into action for them. The target market for hotels can be categorized in business travelers, leisure travelers, and group travelers. Positioning. After identifying the target market, it becomes important to position your product in the potential client mind. According to Kotler, positioning is the act of designing the company's offerings and image to occupy a distinctive place in the mind of the target market. Positioning will help the hotels to differentiate their products and services from their competition. Positioning, in simple words, is building the brand image of your hotel in customers' mind. The STP process is an important element of marketing process. This helps the organization to identify and understand the needs and wants of their prospective client and offer best services which can satisfy the customer's need. Marketing mix for hotels. This basically implies to the number of factors that work together to make an effective marketing plan. Marketing mix is a combination of small elements which work together to achieve the marketing plan of the hotel. There are 7 P's of marketing: product, price, place, promotion, people, physical evidence, and process. Taking product first. Being a service industry, the basic products offered by the hotels are accommodation, food, and beverage. Products like a soft bed in the room, a private bathroom, along with supplementary services like travel desk, business center, a swimming pool, etc., is offered to the guest. Next is people. Hotel industry is highly people-oriented. At every point of service delivery, the customer will come in contact with the staff of the hotel. Therefore, the success of the hotel will depend upon the kind of people they have recruited. The service personnel should be mentally and emotionally sound and should have thorough knowledge of the product and services that are being offered by the hotel. Their behavior, attitude, and appearance will tell a lot about the hotel. Next is pricing. It is difficult to set the prices for services. In a restaurant, the customer is charged for the food, but what about the ambience and the music that you play, who is going to pay for them? Therefore, in hotels, the pricing strategies have to carefully look upon. Hotels can use demand-based, competition-based, and differential pricing strategies. They can also offer discounts like seasonal pricing, tactile discounts, and corporate discounts to its potential clients. Next is place or distribution. The place or location means where the services of a particular organization is either located or can be experienced. When speaking about hotel industry, it is not the hotel that goes to the customer, but the customer comes to the hotel. Therefore, the hotel uses distribution channel like travel agents, sales agents, and event planners, etc., that will reach to the potential customers and market your product to them. Next is promotion. This basically means promoting your products and services through different communication means to the prospective clients. Promoting the hotel services, as it's very easy to duplicate a service, thus promotion will help the customers know what sets you apart from your competitors. Promotion is the only way by which the customer speaks to their target clients. Advertisements, brochures, hotel web pages, social media, logos of hotels, pens, pencils, televisions, commercials are some of the communication channels used by the hotels for promotion of their product and services. Next is process. It means the flow of services to the end customers. It refers to procedures, mechanisms, or set of activities by which services are consumed. For example, in a hotel at front desk, the room boy taking the luggage to the room, the receptionist doing reservation, the cashier doing foreign exchange, etc. Next is physical evidence. The focus of physical evidence is on the tangible components of the service sector. For example, in a restaurant, lighting, decor, good seating arrangement, along with high quality food is offered. A customer is offered a bed to sleep in every hotel, but how much to charge for that bed will depend upon the condition of the room. Now, to summarize the unit, marketing of products and services of a hotel is very vital for the growth. A perfect marketing plan in place will help the shareholders and the hotels to get more profits. There are various means of marketing the product: advertisements, sales promotions, roadshows, etc. The company can choose at its own convenience to choose anyone or a mix of methods to market their product. Just by opening a good hotel and providing the best of the services does not mean that the hotel organization will earn profits. Therefore, for showing the presence in the market and to generate more revenue from the products and services offered by a hotel, marketing of the hotel becomes very important. Thank you for watching EPG Pathshala. This was Dr. Ankur Shambardar from Kurukshetra University.